Good morning. Please stand for the invocation which will be offered by Bishop Donald Jackson.
Eternal God, creator of heaven and earth and all things therein, we thank you for the opportunity to be gathered here together for this occasion. First, we thank you for waking us up this morning in our right mind and having the activity and the use of our limbs and a reasonable portion of health. Father, we thank you for traveling mercy, those that travel near and afar. Now, Lord, as we come together to congratulate and to celebrate the milestone that our students have accomplished, we ask for your blessing upon this place. We thank you, O God, for how they have persevered and accomplished their goal. We thank you, Father, for all those that played a part. We pray blessing upon each and every one, our president and his cabinet, our board of trustees, every staff member, and Lord, especially our faculty, who have poured out a wealth of knowledge to our graduates. Help them to be able to utilize it, open a door of opportunity that they may be able to excel in their next endeavors of life. Now, Lord, we ask as we close, that if there's anyone that is under the sound of my voice that may be stricken with pain, we ask that you send a spirit of deliverance that they may be healed and can rejoice with these, our graduates. We pray this prayer in the matchless name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
roads. In this life that we all travel, there were scars and there were battles where we roam. When we are lost, or wherever we may go, they will always lead me home. There are roads that have led me to another, to a friend or to a lover I have known. For every turn is a year that I have grown as I walk along these roads. Some are long and some are weathered. Some will lead you through a storm. When you've gone astray, you will find your way as you walk roads. There were times that I stumbled and I wondered, but every choice and every step I don't regret, 'cause I have lived and I have loved like no other. I won't fear what lies ahead.
Before we begin, I would like to call your attention to the commencement ceremony etiquette requests listed in your program, and to remind everyone that if you leave the ceremony whilst it is in progress, please exit by the northwest entrance, and remember, you may not be allowed to return immediately. Also, once the degrees have been awarded, the audience will please remain seated until all the graduates have recessed. Thank you for your cooperation. Welcome to our fall commencement. The academic procession was led by the bearer of the faculty mace. The faculty mace leads the academic procession at commencement and on other ceremonial occasions. The mace is carried by a distinguished senior member of the faculty. This morning, the faculty mace is carried by Dr. R. Sethbell Smith, PD Electric Cooperative Professor of Physics. With us this morning, we have some special guests whom I wish to recognize at this time. To begin, I would like to present the First Lady of Francis Marion University, Mrs. Folly Carter. As most of us are aware, The Board of Trustees for Francis Marion University is made up of men and women from throughout the state who give up their time generously and without compensation. It is our pleasure to welcome some of those members to the commencement platform today. I shall ask each to stand when introduced and to remain standing until all have been recognized. Chair of the Board of Trustees, Robert E. Lee, Class of 87, Marion. Trustee George McIntyre, Class of 78, Bennettsville, South Carolina. Trustee Karen Leatherman, Class of 80, Florence, South Carolina. Trustee H. Paul Dove, Winsboro, South Carolina. Trustee Patricia Hartung, Greenville, South Carolina. Trustee R. Tracy Freeman, Class of 92, North Augusta, South Carolina. Trustee J. Kevin O'Kelly, Florence, South Carolina. We appreciate your leadership and thank you for being with us today. The administrative officers comprised of the vice presidents are also seated on stage, and I shall ask each to stand when introduced. Ms. Lauren Stanton, Vice President of Institutional Advancement and Executive Director of the Francis Marion University Foundation. Dr. Charlene Wages, Vice President for Administration. Dr. Darrell Bridges, Vice President for Finance and Facilities. Dr. Christopher Kennedy, Vice President for Student Life. And Dr. Alyssa Waters, Vice President for Enrollment Management. Also seated on stage, and I shall ask each to stand when introduced, Bishop Donald Jackson, Dr. Sharon O'Kelly, Chair of the Faculty, Dr. John Tuttle, Director of the Honors Program, Professor Alison Stedman, Associate Provost, and Ms. Anne Williams, Registrar. And now it is my distinct privilege to present the President of Francis Marion University, Dr. Luther F. Carter. Thank you.
Guests, faculty, graduates, welcome to the fall commencement ceremonies for the class of 2022. You know, it's a beautiful day outside, the perfect occasion to celebrate our new graduates. This weekend we have two ceremonies. Last night we conferred degrees in health sciences and business, and this morning we will confer degrees in education and the liberal arts. But let me begin this morning by describing this graduating class. Across the two ceremonies, 247 will be graduating, 189 undergraduates and 58 graduate students. Among the undergraduates, 22 will graduate with Latin honors and 2 with university honors. The average age of this class is 26 years old, with the youngest member 20 years old and the oldest 55. 237 graduates are from the state of South Carolina. You know, every graduation, I'm delighted at the large number of in-state students educated here. And just a brief note to our legislators in attendance, this university continues to be the best educational investment among all the universities in the state of South Carolina. As the provost mentioned earlier, commencement is the most important event on our calendar. It's a joyous occasion, but it's also a reverent one. It's a time for celebrating your educational success. At the same time, you anticipate, maybe a little nervously, those future opportunities and maybe a few challenges that lie in front of you. Every graduate here knows what you've accomplished. You don't need me to stand up here and tell you that. But now you have to define and decide how most effectively you can apply it. This process could take a few minutes. It could take a few years. It might even take a couple of decades. I know your parents will groan at that, but don't be in a rush. One of the benefits of acquiring a fine university education is it allows you to be more discerning about who you are, what you believe, and the life that you want to pursue. This is especially true in today's society with its politically and socially charged undercurrents. In just a few minutes, you're going to be holding your diploma. Let me remind you that that degree, once earned, can't ever be taken away. In our society, your education defines you not only as a person who has acquired knowledge, but as one who will continue to pursue intellectual development throughout your entire life. Over time, many of our graduates discover that the love of learning is even more gratifying than the acquisition of the knowledge itself. This learning business can become very, very addictive. Just ask my friends on the faculty. Of course, much of the success celebrated today is derived from the wisdom and knowledge of this faculty. They've devoted their careers to university teaching, to university research, and to university service. They planned, developed, and they taught your curriculum. They nurtured your intellectual and scholarly growth. And no one here takes greater pride in your accomplishments than they do, except perhaps your family. But I do want you to understand an important condition necessary for this faculty or any faculty to provide a responsible education. They must have the right to speak and teach freely without encumbrances or constraints. And you, our students, must have the ability to learn unconditionally. Just a couple of minutes ago, I mentioned the socially and politically charged environment with which we all deal today. Well, universities across this country have been adversely affected by this over the past couple of years. We have faced pressures over curricular matters, who should or shouldn't be taught, what instructional materials should be used, where academic responsibility should properly reside. Much of this pressure comes from special interest groups working at the national level and within various states, including our own. Their goal is simple. They want to influence and control what is being taught. But most of society understands that the quality of the education and the value of the degree is dependent upon professors who have freedom to teach without intimidation, without threats, without coercion. Over the course of 4 years, you are subjected to a great many ideas and concepts, some of which you agree, some of which you don't. During this period, your education, your higher education, is shaped from a multitude of different academic perspectives and disciplines, taught by dozens of different professors and influenced by viewpoints of countless others, both within and outside the university. You see, ultimately, the education you acquire is uniquely and distinctly your own. This brings me to a final request. To every graduate here today, we'll make a similar request to our 26,000 alumni and to our many friends and supporters across the state and beyond. Here it is. Give this matter of academic freedom for faculty and students the attention it deserves. Join us in taking up the good fight. When you hear that pressure is put on universities to influence what we can and cannot teach, help us by pushing back hard. The quality of this country's future leadership and the education of your own children and grandchildren depends upon independent and unconstrained voices within its universities. If we ever lose that freedom, then we will have lost much of the essence of democracy, most especially its conscience. While elected officials have an obligation to pass and implement laws ensuring justice and the public good, universities have no less of an obligation to teach openly and freely without fear or favor. Legislative and educational processes work best when they are attentive to and respectful of one another. But hey, all that's Monday's agenda. Today's the time for celebration. Today belongs to you. Savor this education. Treasure the degrees you've earned. Use them for grand and noble ends. And don't forget to thank your families. Good luck and Godspeed.
Before we begin the conferral of degrees this morning, it is my pleasure to announce that honor medallions will be presented to those graduating with university honors during the distribution of undergraduate degrees by Dr. John Tuttle, Director of the Honors Program. And now I call upon the President of the University to come forward. Will the candidates for master's and bachelor's degrees please rise? Mr. President, I am pleased to present these candidates for their respective degrees. Each candidate has completed the required course of study, and each has been approved by the faculty.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees and the faculty of Francis Marion University, I confer upon you your respective degrees with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
I will ask Professor Alison Steadman, Associate Provost, and Ms. Anne Williams, Registrar, to come forward to assist in the presentation of diplomas for the graduate degrees. Will the graduates come forward to receive their diplomas?
Master of Education, Amanda Nicole Klaus. Michelle Patricia Downey. Joni Ariel Perkins. Ashley Caroline Poston. Jennifer Denise Wortham. Michael C. Anderson. Samantha Ryan Black. Anna Hinton Ganey. Deborah Shariba Greenlee. Bonnie Daniel Harding. Catherine McDonald Konoditsiotis. Shanta Diane Shelton. Robert Cornelius Veroni III, Master of Science in Applied Psychology, Kayla Joyce Bodkins, Courtney Elizabeth Bryan, Haley Ginger Clark, Ashley Merritt Floyd, Madison Haley Hughes, Kristen Chestnut Jordan, Halsey Marie Keller, Hannah Elizabeth Medlin, Gabrielle M. Richards, Leslie Kathleen Self. At this time, we present the candidates for the undergraduate degrees. I wish to ask Dr. Alyssa Waters, Vice President for Enrollment Management, to come forward to assist in the presentation of diplomas for the undergraduate degrees. Will the graduates please come forward to receive your diplomas?
College of Liberal Arts, Bachelor of General Studies, ex Abriana Monet Butler. Keisha Cox. Raven Shaquana Dolores McDowell. Kylie Marie Rainwater. Tristan Reese Sherd, cum laude. Bachelor of Science, Victoria Atlas. Vladimir Soshin Bulaknin, magna cum laude. Summer Matthews Barrett, cum laude. Jasmine Bellamy. Adiana Nyasia Yashima Binbo. Saeed F. Bernard. Titihana Kiera Bishop. Sydney Janae Boggs. Stephen Allen Brown, magna cum laude. Tamara Faith Campbell. Patrick M. Chellen. Crystal Angel Risha Cord, cum laude. Wendy Courtney with University Honors. Serena Creasy, cum laude. Maria Isabella Darby. Maya Nicole David. Malachi Kalik Dawson. Yeah. Lyle DiTallo. Selena Simone DeWitt. Alicia Marie Eldridge. Jessica Lynn Evans. Bonita Zion Gonzalez. Sierra Latavial Graham. Courtney Ryan Gray. Nigeria Alika Green. Doneria Shaunice Harrington. Kayla Nicole Helming. Charles Berkeley Harrington. Caitlin H. Hicks. Tori Renee Hubbard, magna cum laude. Ariana Michelle Jackson. Robert Harper Jackson. Stephen Mackenzie Josie, summa cum laude. Alexander Robert Kellerhaus. Janae Laws. Rashetta Marsh. Jania Nicole McCall. Nicole Danielle McDonald, cum laude. DeAndrea Danae McKelvey, magna cum laude. Talon Graham McPherson, cum laude. John Christopher Kennedy Mills. Daisha Danielle Molette, cum laude. Erica Daishika Moses. Jared Chapman Odom. Blakely Elizabeth Owens, summa cum laude. Mason Grant Oxendine. Harmony Jade Parker. Carla Perez Victoria. Caitlin Elena Poston. Sydney A. Price. C. Ciesia Brianna Rivera. Nicholas Paul Rock. Gianna Scuderi, cum laude. Matthew Jink Skipper, summa cum laude. Jelana Tamia Smalls. Tangi Michelle Smith. Janice Mariah Spann. Rachel Leah Stevens. Bonnie Christine Tanner, cum laude. Iyanla Monique Thigpen. Jonathan Antoine Wilson, Jr. Bachelor of Arts, Alaria Nijay Abraham, cum laude. Aaliyah Broadus. Victoria Elizabeth Locklear. Michaela Marie O'Neill. Christian Elizabeth Reason. Hans Peter Rodell. Alexis Lauren Smith. Tyler Janae Smith. Chelsea Brianna Taylor. School of Education, Bachelor of Science, Bethany Margaret Alford, magna cum laude. Chloe Elizabeth Allen, cum laude. Brianna Louise Ard. Kaylee Brianna Babb. Madison Blake Canty, summa cum laude. Gracie Diane Epps, cum laude. Tynice Hemingway. Logan Elizabeth Holliday, cum laude. Lauren Elizabeth Hyman, magna cum laude. Carmen Brianna Jernigan. Kristen Noelle Jones. Caitlin Jaggers McInnes. Hannah Brooke Miller. Jessica Simone Smith. Wow. Annabelle Tedder, cum laude.
Ladies and gentlemen, the class of fall 2022. To the members of the audience, for reasons of courtesy and safety, we ask that you remain seated until the academic procession and all of the graduates have recessed. Following these proceedings, there will be a reception for graduates and guests on the lawn outside of the University Center. Now, as we conclude, a university is only as good as its faculty. And Francis Marion University is fortunate to have an outstanding faculty. Graduates, please rise, face the faculty, and thank them for all they have done. You also have family and friends here today. Graduates, please thank them for all their many years of support. And now for the benediction, Bishop Donald Jackson.
The Lord bless you and the Lord keep you. The Lord be gracious unto thee and make his sun shine upon thee and give you peace. May he dispatch his angels to give us traveling mercy back to our destinations. Amen.
This concludes our fall 2022 commencement. Please remain seated until all the graduates have recessed.
Don't be mad.